Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
there would actually be a day within these horrid times, you know, the COVID times, where I'd actually catch a laugh, you know, like real laugh, chuckle a minute. Aye! Ladies and gentlemen, it happens to be Monday. Back in the day before Corona happened to the world, my Mondays were usually motivational. It was always something like, you know, you know what today used to sound my status? I've even forgotten it. Every Monday. Oh yeah, it was always money-making Mondays. Now it's pretty much get through it Mondays. But all of that aside, how are you all doing? I know you're all seated at home. For all of you who are practicing staying safe and staying home, what up? For all of you who understand what social distancing is, what up? My name is Tina Fierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop, proudly sponsored by Coca-Cola, the guys who gave us jerrycans. Yes. Y'all people need to understand that Nani manyeri nitu evi mubi genda chuka Bande kamba guli debit Ebisena bia corona viva debit Uti sizanyo. So in a way I thought we're going to change a couple of things. You know, we're going to be a little bit more I don't know, I expected changes. Not just munjara na butakola, but you know, personal individual growth on most of our sides. Kakuti, there's a couple of things that I saw over the weekend. I wasn't here on, I was here on Friday, but wali wa byansu kako byayitawo over the weekend. Ntandikide wa banange. I want to take this opportune moment. I am usually the savage one. I am usually the one who is not at a lack for mean things to say. But you Ugandans, my Jesus. So, Christopher Thomas Duke, or Christopher Duke Thomas, Mumujukiroyo, the guy who came and told us that the Toro Princess's coochie actually was infested with tons of STDs. That guy. Ah, he did not just stop at that. He actually went ahead and married her. Oh, she married him, whichever it was. That guy, the American who came here and he thought he could be royalty. Anyway, that punk. Ah, let me tell you. I have seen people transition into things. I do not know what Christopher Thomas has been transitioning into. My Jesus. So over the course of the week, the end of the week actually, yawereza kafana nikaso kembuza bali mu studio. Bide. Kazi wa Christopher Duke wa mlabye. Antaira. Mbulira. Wa mlabye. Oina bido wazochi. Look here. I am not going to say what you people were saying. You people were calling her ugly. You people were saying, oh my goodness. When I saw that photo, I was like, wow, he is actually a she. But that is besides my thoughts until I found out that it's a she and actually happens to also be a baby mama. I'm like, whoa, why are we as a generation, as a nation, as people? Watch it better. Almost a jayerondere chintu che. Mubanzu. Yaronde chintu che. Choche nini che mwalaba. Nagamba, he's going to wife it. They even have a child. And then all of you started doing this photo grid of putting Komuntale and his new wife. Like someone asked me, like, what do you think? That chick may be rich or something. I'm like, you know, she may not even have the money, but I never told you. Baby Tawati did. You know, there's those chicks who don't have much going on for them. Naenga bo mugwa mum fotova yo batagera bo, batagera. She might be one of them. Like, why do people have to be rude and call her ugly? I'm not lying. They just need to teach her how to take better selfies, because there's that photo of her with the black shades in the car. That wasn't even fit to be a mugshot. I don't know what. Anyway. I just felt I needed to say, you know, like, speak on it. I was numb. When he came out and he said, this is Lobe, I was like, oh, wow, Christopher. But before we can even talk about his bae, who I personally have no problem with, I honestly, beauty lies in the hands of the beholder. What is happening with Christopher's hair? Mwamulabye. Ezo si wuzi. Bamusibye mu tapua. Munjukira kwetu aitanga tapua. Na yo munene. What twist? Like, what's happening in the Duke's life? Aish. Now I think it's true. What they say is true. There's some people who tie up sinikida kwa manyo. Kati kwogene mu bigali bya a royal. Otubulire how that royal has STDs and you think you'll stay normal. You can't be normal. Oloza ebigali babikwata. Huh? Because last time I checked, damn, this guy has way too many baby mamas, way too many side chicks, way too many. But we wish him. The story was, by the way, that I was actually congratulating him on finding new love. For this time that we're all home. Scared, but like we are scared. People are scared. They're either scared of getting corona, or most importantly, they're scared about what they're going to eat during the corona, or most importantly, they're scared about what's going to happen post-corona. So you have to get used to me giving you reliable information, reliable nonsense. Some things we'll take serious, some things we won't. I just don't want to burden my viewers with so much seriousness, but here goes a little bit of serious.
Jesus.
So, I saw a story online, caught my attention. Here's how it caught my attention. You know how I'm trying to dodge things on social media because I feel like the media is going to brew so much fear in people. So I'm trying to cut down on my, you know, screen time when it comes to how much I'm seeing that's happening in the world. So I happen to be on one of the pages that actually usually makes me happy because it just puts up random, you know, celebrity nonsense. And then you need to understand that this is an American, it is an American site. It is not Ugandan, right? And then I saw the story about Bobby Wine getting together with different CEOs about, what was it? Is he just bringing Ugandans back or pretty much every African within, in China? I don't know how, my name is at this point, Tevin Kwatako, and I saw it on another, I think I saw it on the CNN page or BBC or something like that. I'm like, wait, what? So I rushed to his Twitter to find out what exactly is going down. And that is actually what's happening. He's talking to different types of, to different CEOs around the world, you know, try and see how they can bring people back home. I'm like, hey, so this is where I'm going to go. I'm going to be on. I feel like at times we need to put our petty politics on the side, you know? And just, this is a global pandemic. Now you need to understand, I feel so sorry for any of our brothers and sisters that are outside in the diaspora right now. It's sad, it's scary that you want to be home but you can't be home. This wasn't planned. This is, you know, it just happened. It's global, it's not for one place, it is global. Now, that said, I wanted, for once, let me tell you, having ideas, having plans is such a beautiful thing. But I wanted, for once, just, when Bobby Wine starts up something that is this serious and that is giving him so much coverage all over the globe, that he would at least have a plan, a definitive one. And not just have a definitive plan, I want for him to tell me his definitive plan. Do you know why I want for him to tell me his definitive plan? Because one, I am a Ugandan. I have 50, how many cases are they right now? There are about 55 confirmed cases in my country of COVID-19. You get what I'm saying? Biggest majority of them is actually, they got it from out there. Now, you are telling me you're going to pick up my brothers and sisters, and I'm like, good for you, word, nice. But my question is, how are you going to do this? I have questions, that's why I'm asking for a plan. As in, nyonyiche gendo bachima. How many countries are going to open up their airports just for you to pick their people? And when they get here, yes, they're going to be in quarantine. When they get here, who is going? There's going to be so much. Where are they going to stay? Where are they going to eat? How are you going to relocate them into different lives? Because let's face it, I hate to be the one saying this because I've seen the media do what we do best, spread news like a wildfire. So I'm seeing all these WhatsApp videos of our brothers and sisters out there being treated to crazy, crazy racism, and I was appalled. In this day and era, I don't think racism should be a thing, especially when it comes to a global pandemic. Apparently, the Chinese are mistreating the black people out there. I was pissed. I'm like, do those idiots know? Do the Chinese know how many they are in the f-ing world? You are all over the place. You're like Nigerians. You can find a Nigerian in Kazakhstan. I swear, I kid you not. Anywho, that was the emotion of me. So I decided to ask about what's this going on. And some person told me, like, look here, there's actually a structure down in China for people to actually get tested, for people to be safe. They want everybody, pretty much, it's kind of like a registration. So when you get the test and you're COVID-free, you're written down in the book. Now, the problem is that most of the black people, yes, I'm going to use the word because you wanted to throw it at race, most of the black African community that is in China and all those other countries are there as immigrants. They are not supposed to be there. They are honestly not supposed to be there. So because they are illegal immigrants, they cannot access most of the things that the government wants them to access. So look here, the government says, if you can't get tested, then we cannot do much for you. Tells every landlord, every hotel owner, everybody, if your person doesn't want to get tested, then there's nothing we can do. They can't have them on their premises. But then again, I can't believe that to the truth, to a dot. I can't. I honestly can't. But what is your strategy? Because I am tired of you using all the simple, tiny problems that happen with, about, and around us to garner some good, you know, media popularity out of it. This is the big boys table I was telling you about, Bobby Wine. This is how you get called to the big boys table. Now, if you're telling me you're in sync with international CEOs and still are not in sync with my government that is trying to keep me safe or Muntuwa1C, there's a problem. That disconnect, I don't understand it. I'm not attacking him. I'm just saying, at times I hate to see when how many international airspaces are you going to get open to just bring these people? Why not wait for it to die out? Better yet, do the people you want to get from there, do they want to come back home? And let's not forget, the grass is greener. How green is it now? How green is it? How have y'all been surviving as illegal immigrants in countries that are not yours for years? It means you know how to build a system. It means you know how to take care of you. So for now, I would rather protect the 46 million, the 56 billion Benyine, Uganda, and just send relief and aid to the ones who are out there as we wait for this to die out. I'm just thinking, but please, Bobby Wine, educate me. You and your people, educate me. What is the plan? Then walk me through it. I want to know. Tujali nyanyoni, tutuke ku airport, tukolewe tuti, tukolewe tuti, tukomeo. I'll sign that petition. I will. I just need to know I'm safe. Ngebya bichali awo, my president's addresses. There were some highlights. Did you all see those highlights? I just want to know, Madam Ameria. Ameria, hey, did you people see that? I think Temwakalabi. First of all, Ameria Chambade, Mrs. Ameria Chambade, Yazenga Kozaka Vidi. But then Manido Saruni has a gun. She has a personal hairdresser. It's just a question. Hey, car. I not personal hairdresser, Abeda, wow, don't get Nakubao for the next couple of until Corona is in. Jesus, but that wasn't even what scared me. You people, if you're ever in a position where you can talk to a person in power and they do what my president did yesterday on national television, Abby, you have made it in life. Mr. President, I'm getting to the border being stopped at 2. It's okay, amnesty granted. But again, Mr. President, there are some that had been arrested. It's okay, done with us, like, Daddy. How is Ameria getting things to be just Temwakalabi? Omkazi abadde ayogerera bigambi nga bagambirawo amnesty granted. Daddy, yes, my Jesus. Ori as thou see ali abikolanga. Kati Ameria yaze mu kifo. Naye munsonyiwe. Bana inaitwa yanziza nyu Ameria. That is one thing I wanted to honestly say. I was so proud of her because she honestly spoke. Ngomuntu wa wansa abona abona tweyanziza. Though we shall want to have a sit down with you to see how even us Dabazukuru can get our father, the grandfather, to just grant us things like that. Amnesty, granted. Don't arrest them. Let them work. 5 p.m. aside. Sorry. Okay. That aside, now let us get to the meat of the president's address. I need to understand what my vice president, the patron saint of stay safe and social distancing, secondly, oh, you have my president, a very busy man, trying to run a nation that is dealing with a global pandemic, reading out donations from Little Puzzle Runabe. You have my president reading out Enkumisha to Zibaherezom COVID relief. You have my president reading out packets of gorillas. First of all, what are gorillas going to do for me in this here moment? Why are we donating nonsense? I'm such a yabagandi. Twagala mamoto ka. Kati ya donating za gorirozi. Bagenda zikabira bana bali mu maka. Obabuli kawunga kilo biri kana jiranga ko gorirozi. I'm like, little puzzle, first of all, banaye. Twayanziza nyo kutua. Because we all know in the past couple of days before you got your COVID relief or to give back. Nae kenyini wali olikubu yambi. Tuwali tunonyengiri jetu kusondida. So wema omutimi omuga. Omutimi omugabi. Bamu wanaena agaba. Na hebo yali avayo kuwa donation ni bamu siva. Kavindi yonkalina. Oh God. Anyway. Still talking about these addresses. I seriously want to know why my president's team doesn't understand that him standing up there or sitting, because he's sitting, to read for us donations that are longer than the address itself. I mean, yo, dude, mukakoche mumukolera. There is secondi. There is a prime minister. There are MPs who have absolutely nothing to do. Baba keza kumacha baba imirize kazinda lo kuredio station ibuongere. Aba gabye bintu. Mukola bichibino. The man had to read out 3 bars of soap. I'm like, ah, that's just about it. I was supposed to actually get into detail about the racism that's happening globally around the world. It's either us being racist towards Chinese or the Chinese being racist towards us. And it's not just happening between black people and Chinese people. I think our biggest issue was how the messages were relayed in regards to this pandemic is what actually caught us off guard. You get what I'm saying? People are so absolutely scared that they will just say what they have to say just to get it out there and run away, not caring to explain. So I believe that our racial slurs at the moment are in regards to bad communication. That's what I think. I feel like if we can communicate better as a people, we wouldn't have all of this. But hey, we're still trying to get to the bottom of it. That's what we're trying to do. Find out if it's really racist, if the Chinese government can speak on it. I bet they have spoken on it. I saw the AU, former AU ambassador to America. Oh, she is such a beautiful woman. That woman speaks so much truth. She wants Africa awake. But my thing is, we can wake Africa up without turning us into what we are not. We are naturally a hospitable, loving type of people. We do not have to become as evil as the rest. We can still keep who we are and still stay woke. I'm just, how we're going to do that is going to be a journey, but we'll get there. So yes, I will get into the whole racial bit about what's happening in China and all these other different countries, because y'all may be saying the Chinese are being racist to us, and yet in another country, they're being racist to the Chinese. So This thing, it all started when Trump just had to damn call it the Chinese virus. But now America, superpower, how you doing? Chitty chitty, yeah. And what's this all? Have you seen all the stories on Facebook and what's not, where they're always prophesying doom upon Africa? Oh, Melinda Gates was like, I prophesy bodies on the streets of Africa before I know it. Every specialist is saying, oh, Chigenda Kwata level Africa. D. 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 Come on, Africa, we're better than this. We shall not let people predict. We are known for survival. Do you know what it means to live on the dark continent? Now they wish they knew how to survive on this dark continent. Ever since this whole thing broke out, Africa has been, you know, on the steady rise. We're fighting. We're not doing as bad as they are. So why is the media so much interested in hearing how bad it's going to hit Africa? That's a question that we need to start asking ourselves. Like, can you imagine? I read a heading something like, oh my goodness, over 1,000 people have died in Africa due to COVID-19. I was like, okay, that is Africa as a continent. Africa is not a country. It's a continent. And if it's 1,000, how many have died in America? How many have died in France? How many have died in Spain? How many have died globally? Like, we need to stop focusing on trying to understand why some places are not hit or are hit hard or hit less, and concentrate on just trying to stay alive. Why do you have to? I just feel like the Western media has it out for us. Like, they believe in getting ebizibu byonna gye bitandikire eno. Ebola n'abasabula, kolera n'abasabula, enjala n'abasabula. Temuina masanyalazi, temuina mazi, temuina any of these things. So they expect everything bad to happen. Well, I have news for you, Africa. This is the time when you can take it all back. If this corona has given us a clean, white slate, as countries, as governments, as economies, this is a clean slate. Like, whatever we decide to do as Africa moving on forward can either make us, break us, indebt us, or set us free. So it's entirely up to us. It's entirely up to us. All the negativity, Africa, this is your chance to use it. You use whatever it is that you have around you. Atemusoma. I don't know why people told people out there that we don't study in Africa. We do. Start using it. That's just me trying to, you know, throw some black love out there. I'm just saying, it's our chance. It's our chance and it's our time. Anywho, all of that aside, it's been a good day. It's been a rather lovely day. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop under TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at TinaFierce1 with an H. And on Snapchat, it's TinaFierce1. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. It's going to be a Tuesday. I hope we have something dumb to talk about or something funny. Ngabayo MP ngabamukubya abaka. Eh? Ngabakubyeyo MP omu. Ngabamanyi COVID relief yatuke uwe na yenga tebanajifunde. You never know. Wishful thinking. I'm out. Stay safe. Wash your hands. Social distancing is real. The curve will go down. Catch you tomorrow. I'm out. Peace.
Scuba Scoop is sponsored by